Hey guys, if you're a cursor beginner like me, you're probably also making the same mistakes that I did in the past. I've been working with cursor quite extensively over the past, I would say, 4 to 6 weeks. I've already built some apps. What you can see here is for another video that I'm producing right now. It's a travel planner AI, but what I wanted to talk about in this video is the 5 top beginner mistakes with cursor. So the first one being trying to explain your app design to cursor. I mean, the app design I'm building right now, you can see it here. So this is always a viable solution, right? You just take a screenshot of your app and you give it to cursor. You reference it with an at sign. Travel planner, and you say, build me something like this, okay? And this is a good solution. However, cursor doesn't get it right on the first try, but it's pretty easy to adjust the design from there. But it's almost impossible, or I would say it takes a long time to explain your design to cursor from scratch, right? Because you have to define everything. You have to tell it the font, the sizes, and the colors, and you have to be very specific in your explanation and in your descriptions, because cursor, if you're using Claude 3.5 Sonnet, it's pretty good, but as far as design, the models are still quite in their infancy, right? And that's why I wanted to show you some other solutions for, or some other ways for that. First, there's a tool called Uizard, which basically is, it feels like Figma, okay? And they have an AI component built inside of it, which is Auto Designer 2.0. And there you can explain your design, and it creates pretty decent designs, as you can see here in the video. So, and then you can just take a screenshot of the design, feed it to cursor, and let cursor build the same. One caveat to this tool, however, is they have a free version, and you have a quota of 400 components that you can create with the Auto Designer 2.0. However, you're pretty quickly max out the 400 components if you decide to build a bigger app, you can imagine. Now, another caveat is that you can only export the code for one component, which means in this example, you could only click the button and export the code for the button, which is also a bit tedious, because if you have a big app, you have to click each and every component. That's why in the past I've used the tool to generate the design and then take a screenshot and feed it to cursor. I've created the front-end design for this travel planner AI app with Uizard. Now everybody and their grandmother is talking about V0. This is also a viable solution. It works pretty well. Just know that you have to have a little bit of I wouldn't say coding experience, but you have to know where you have to copy and paste the code inside of your project. So there's a little bit of a learning curve, but nothing too fancy. And the third solution is, if you've worked with Figma before, I think Anima, it's also, yeah, it's a Figma add-on, right? And once you've designed your, or created your design in Figma, you can use Anima to basically export your components as code and insert them into cursor. So the second mistake that I've made is I've tried to work on too many features in the past. And with cursor, I mean, it's pretty powerful, but you still have to be able to think like a developer, right? And when a developer decides to build an app, he has the idea, but he also thinks about the different components of this idea, right? So for example, if we're taking this travel pen AI, so the overall features are The user can input their destination, start date, end date, preferences, and budget. I make an API call to Claude. In the background, Claude creates this itinerary for the different dates, as you can see here. And we also make two other API requests to Mapbox API and to Open Weather. So in total, we have like three features as far as the API requests go. But you still have to think about how to fetch or in what way Claude needs to respond with the data. So in this case, I told it to respond with a JSON object so that I can parse the so that I can parse the response better. And those teeny tiny things are things you have to think about while you're building the app. Okay, so you have to really put your developer hat on and tackle each feature one by one. And if you do this, Cursor is pretty powerful. But if you just tell it to build me the next Facebook, you will probably only get one huge file. It will look pretty shitty in terms of design. And the debugging also becomes quite impossible, because if you have a big file with, like, I don't know, 500, 600, 700 lines of code or even more, at the end of the day, you don't really know what each line is really doing. The next beginner mistake is not adding documentations to Cursor. Now, like every AI model, Cursor has been trained on data, right? That data, especially for the different documentations like Next.js or other libraries that you're working with, can be outdated, okay? Especially in the tech sector, everything is moving so fast. That's why Cursor has a pretty neat feature where if you're in the chat, you can hit add and click on documentation, and you can add new documentations to Cursor, okay? And what this does is Cursor is parsing the web page of that specific documentation and adds it to its database, basically. So you have an up-to-date documentation. As you can see here, for example, I added Expo Docs with React Native, which is basically a tool with that you can use to build mobile applications. And as you can see, it was indexed 2 days ago. Now, if you click on the cogwheel, you are basically redirected to the Cursor settings, where I think it's in features. Let me check. Yeah. So if you click on the cogwheel on the top right, or when you're in the chat window, you click on features, and here you can see a list of the docs, and you can always hit refresh, and Cursor will start to index the documentation again so that you're always up to date. This is huge, especially if you're trying to work with, for example, authentication with Clerk or something. There are quite a bit of nuances when it comes to creating such things as authentication or other complicated stuff. And if you don't use up-to-date code base, it's nearly impossible to get it to work. Okay. So the next beginner mistake is not using long context window. As you probably know, Cursor is using Claude 3.5 Sonnet under the hood. I mean, you can choose different GPT models, but as far as my experience goes, you will get the best results with Claude 3.5 Sonnet. And again, if you're in the settings and you hit the beta tab, you have the long context chat, which basically enables you to use Claude's 200k token context window. And especially for bigger apps, this is godsend, right? Because you can give more context, or aka more files, to Cursor's context window, and the chance of Cursor producing working code by having a bigger context window is much higher than if you would just add one specific file, especially when you're working with state management libraries like Redux, because oftentimes you need to use the state across different files, and well, projects can become very big very quickly. Okay, let's put it that way. And the last mistake I want to talk about is not using Cursor Composer. So as you already, as you probably know, if you hit Command and L, you can open the chat window. If you hit Command and I, you can open the Composer. If you hit Command Shift and I, you can open a new Composer window. And the main advantage of Cursor Composer is that it will automatically create the files for you. Okay, so especially if you're starting a project and you have a clear idea in mind what that project should do, what features you want to have, you can tell all those features to Cursor, and it will go ahead and create the necessary file structure, create folders, and put everything in the right place. And the last thing that just came to my mind is not using Cursor rules. Okay, so I mean, Cursor is pretty powerful from straight out of the box, but you can still make it even better. So again, if you hit the settings and you click on the general tab, you will find the rules for AI section. And this is basically the system prompt for the AI model, I think, I guess you could say. And here you can give it more thorough explanation of what the AI's job is. Okay, so for example, I've added a cursor rule which says, okay, you're an expert in TypeScript, React Native, expert in mobile UI development. And I give it a bunch of rules for code style, naming conventions, TypeScript usage, syntax and formatting, UI and styling. And there's a page called Cursor Directory, I believe. Yes. And there you can grab all of the different cursor rules that are a fit for your specific project you're working on right now. Okay. Now, okay, guys, I hope the video helps. At least for me, it improved my workflow big time, and maybe it can help you too. Okay, so take care.